weather. I've got spring fever.
It almost feels like spring. Average temperatures for early May would be about this.
So. Wow. Okay. Flip-flop season, here we come.
Yeah, exactly. Well, kind of on a different note, we have a new segment here on WCBI. It will air every Sunday. It's called WCBI Weather Works. We'll talk about different aspects of weather in addition to other science stories. So something a little bit fun to spice up our Sunday newscast. So without any further ado, here's our first WCBI Weather Works episode. You may have noticed the symbols in our logo. They are symbols that you might find on a station model. Today we'll talk a little bit about what a station model is and what the symbols mean. Station models are a compact way of displaying lots of weather information for a specific location. Generally, you will see a map of station models, such as this one for the U.S. Every station has a few key aspects. They are temperature, dew point, pressure, cloud cover, and wind speed and direction. We'll talk more about station models another week, but some station models also show a weather symbol, such as this one. But what do these symbols mean? Well, let's start with the two in our logo. The first, found in place of the R in weather, is the symbol for thunderstorm. This is shown when a station reports lightning. The second symbol, found in place of the S in works, is the symbol for a sandstorm or dust storm. Now that we have those covered, what are some other common weather symbols? Well, both rain and snow have a three-tiered system that indicate light, moderate, or heavy precipitation. For rain, the symbols are circles, but for snow, they are small snowflakes. There is one other commonly used symbol, fog. Generally, it consists of two parallel lines, but a third may be added for very dense fog. There are many other symbols for different weather phenomena, including freezing rain, sleet, haze, a funnel cloud, and even smoke. With this week's WCBI Weatherworks, I'm meteorologist Amanda Reynolds.